Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video guys, we'll be working here on a Dodge Journey guys. So if you have a Dodge Journey or Fiat Fremont, the video will be very helpful to you guys. Let me introduce you to the channel guys. We'll have more than 200 videos on this car. More than 200 videos, you heard it right. So please guys, subscribe. Our mission is to save you as much money as we can. What we'll be doing today, we'll explain where the coolant temperature sensor is located. Now, if your coolant gauge does not work on the inside, okay, let's say you start the car, your coolant gauge doesn't work, doesn't show the correct temperature, okay, right there, it could be a bad sensor. And we'll have a video how to test those. It will be on the channel, not very complicated video. Also, okay, if you open the hood, okay, this is for the 3.6 engine. If you open the hood, the only thing missing right now is the engine cover. We got it out of the way so we can show you a little bit better, but with the engine cover removed now, okay, if you come towards the right side of the engine, okay, this is bank 2 of the engine, okay, check out now, okay, that sensor right here with the red connector, okay, this is, guys, your coolant temperature sensor right there, okay, this one down there. This is the sensor guys, that's the one that reads the temperature, that's the one that tells the gauge what the temperature is, that's the sensor that controls the computer and the fan as well. Never ever stick your hands here if the engine is hot, because check it out, the fan is right there and it might turn on you anytime. So if you guys need to remove that sensor, we have the video on the channel how to remove and replace it. You will have to drain the coolant. So in order to drain the coolant, you need to jack the car up. There is one plastic underneath you need to remove and drain the coolant. The plug is kind of like right there. After you drain the coolant, okay, I would definitely recommend to disconnect the car battery. We have the video again that explains that on the channel. And then you can just go ahead and remove that sensor. Once you disconnect it, you can use a socket to access the sensor. It's not so complicated. You can move those pipes a little bit out of the way if they're in the way, but that's where it's located guys. Hopefully the video will be helpful for replacing it as well. Super simple after that. So thank you for watching and see you guys next time.